do you make sure that the state change you induce by provocation, by activities, by the application of particular patterns, will transfer out? Now, notice the answer to your question is the same as the answer to her question. If you have a representation of the context where they want the new choices and new qualities, put them in there and you'll know. Because the whole point of these high-performance games that come out of NASA and Alphabet and so forth is to create a high-performance safe and then associate it with all of the signals that you're in the context where you want the new behaviors to generate. But this is important. Carmen will give you a much more sophisticated sort of flowchart, roadmap of the matrix of choices. Do not assume these are sequential. You can do any of them at any point. The only stuff that I really urge you to put up front is that checklist that we've been through a number of times. Rapport, establish rapport and test for it if you're not sure. Make sure that your calibration skills are up and running beautifully, which you have to have for the rapport exercise anyway. That your state and the state of decline are adequate for what you're about to have them do. Period. Everything else is unordered. You can do any of these things at any point. Before you even ask them to put a context there, you can have them go into a high-performance state. Their ability to put a context there will be enhanced. And then you can send them in there with a new state. So there is no strict ordering of the interventions. These are choices that you can exercise capriciously. Capriciously. I like capricious stuff.
Do you ask for the intention?
Me? No. You? Yes.
What would be the reason for me to ask him?
Because I have calibration skills you don't have. So I will find the intention, non-verbally, typically, by the nuanced differences in the way they respond as I'm talking, as they're talking, as they're doing things. So, sure, sometimes I go, in my usual support, what the hell are you doing here? You have my attention. What do you want? I mean, is that asking for the intention? If they say, I want to be able to do X and it's a behavioral description, I go, you could go back into history, which I don't recommend. Have you ever succeeded in doing that? Show me the state you were in when you did it. So maybe I'll steal a state from the past. In general, I like fresh states. The states you get out of the games tend to be much stronger, much more advanced, much more impactful than going back and taking one from personal history. Plus, if you take it from personal history, you drag along a lot of crap that has no part of the context you're in. The remarkable thing about these games, like NASA and Alphabet, is they don't touch Alphabet. They have no content to them. These are purely manipulations, provocations to your nervous system and the nervous system of the client to put themselves in a state where they can generate new choices and have the quality of experience that they're seeking. So for 20-some years, I have taught psychotherapists and psychoanalysts and psychiatrists to use these patterns. Are they doing psychotherapy? Are they doing psychoanalysis? I don't know. They're doing change work. The name only carries expectations, and most of the expectations associated with psychoanalysis and psychotherapy are negative. If you don't believe me, hide yourself. When you know a client is coming at 10 o'clock, at 10 minutes before 10, hide yourself in some place you can see. They'll be walking along the street, beautiful sunny day here in Spain, happy, responding to the little child there, saying buenos dias to the grandma who's passing by, the abuela. And they see your office and they go, complete state change. They got to get ready to suffer. This is insane. Remember, the problem is not the problem. The problem is the state that your client approaches the context where they think the problem is.
Yep.
If you can remember that and operationalize it, you can do miracles. So Rocky, would you give a short description of what happened? This is a professional actor, and he's good. He was playing a female. There were tears coursing down his cheeks. He got so nicely into the role. It was a very impressive piece of acting. And then I stepped in. Rocky, describe what happened.
So
Yeah, it was good fun. Nice little bit of acting going on. And John crops up and says, okay, we'll do this, and takes over. And the actor part of me, in the back of my mind, thought, fuck you, I am going to stay in role. You are not going to break me out of role. And he broke me out of role. Within probably about 15, 20 seconds.
And the done. Specific intervention was?
Specific intervention was a physical intervention, which is throwing balls backwards and forwards, and then he starts to become more and more specific about the situation.
The
content, which was just it? Was, it was and impossible
and
to say character.
It was, so he broke out of the state and blah, blah, blah. Now, I call this to your attention because the single deepest wish I have, having watched you perform as a group in this last exercise, is to shut your mouth and do something. You don't need, look, remember the thing I drew here? Unconscious, conscious? Yeah, well, if you need the crutch, get some conscious information. It'll make you relax and probably go into a state that, or just go for it. As Rafi said, a professional actor who has made an explicit conscious, unconscious decision, that bastard Gringer is not going to shake me out of my role. I'm going to maintain this no matter what happens. 20 seconds later, he's out. What I did, I threw balls at him, and he threw them back. And we continued the conversation. Now, the only reason Rafi and I continued the conversation, the content of the context where the person, the client he was playing, wanted choices, was because I wanted to connect the new state with that context. That's equivalent to sending him into a state that's already, a context that's already been prepared. That's the connection between the state and the context. Remember I said, new code is a collision between states and contexts? So you need the choice of identifying, is this client in a state where they can create new choices, improve the quality of their performance? If not, do nothing else to change the state. Or do it simultaneously, as Rafi and I did. Some simple thing like a little piece of the great ball game, just tossing balls back and forth. When they get back in that context, they will automatically go back into that state. They'll be triggered back into the state that they were in and start to do things they've never done before in the most positive way in that context. Remember the Vogue diagram. You can work consciously at this end with specification questions, manipulating representational systems, et cetera, and get information, which may be useful in coming to an appreciation of the intention that the client has, whether they know it consciously or not. That's an important caveat. Many of your clients will arrive with an explicit intention, but it's pretty superficial relative to the underlying, or what Carmen refers to as the hidden intention. You can discover it if you're clever with sort of conscious mind-oriented tools like the verbal package and representation system, blah, blah, blah. Or you could just jump in, either simultaneously with the conversation, throwing balls back and forth, officially establishing the context, doing the alphabet game, shoving them back into the context, bam, explosion. Okay, so when you're doing a meta model at the beginning, you've got rapport, you check your statement, and you're doing calibration. And now you start, okay, what specifically did you come here for? If you walked out the door right now carrying something new, what would you be carrying? I mean, different ways of asking the same question, right? Now, I'd recommend, and for you for the next exercise, I want you all to get balls or some activity so that when you do this information gathering, you're simultaneously manipulating their state at the physiological level. And you'll notice that it goes so much faster, cleaner, and it makes your job easy. If you've got a client in a high-performance state, it's a pleasure. If they're not in a state, it changes the resources that are ultimately going to be the source of the new choices and new quality in their life. It's just like running through molasses. And it takes a long time, and it's boring for you, and I'm sure boring, if it's boring for you, it's going to be boring for the client. If you have an unmotivated client, you're wasting your time, so is your client. So motivate. Change the state. Get them into some kind of a state where they can actually respond to what you're proposing. Somebody, I'm sure, has asked themselves, although I haven't heard the question out loud yet, how do you decide, John, whether you use a verbal package or you jump right into a high-performance state. What has been remarkable to me over the years is that the games that you play, these five or six games you play, seem to adapt themselves to any context. They seem to be almost universal high-performance states. I for a long time, I worked hard to try to find counterexamples to the effectiveness of these high-performance states.